Hey, what's up YouTube? I went and I did another application. This application is a little bit different. It is a registry editor, read and write to specific locations inside the registry. I will also confirm with my virus protection running in the background that this program is legit. And you can edit specific values and stuff inside the registry. Okay? So, as you can see here, we have three text boxes. And we have two buttons. First text box is called, believe it or not, it's called key name text. Second text box, its name is a value name text. See? Key name text, value name text, and value text is a third. Okay? And two buttons. First button called read is called read. Second button that's called write is called write. Let's go inside of our code here and let's go ahead and take a look. Alright, here we are. As you notice on top here, I have imports Microsoft.132. We're going to be dealing with the registry values inside the registry. Okay, for the read click, when you click on the read button, I have three variables set up here. Dim key name as string equals key name text dot text. Dim value name as string equals value name text dot text. And dim value as object equals value text dot text. Okay, now I didn't really understand this before, but now I understand that it's actually reading the value, so you need to assign which text box will be receiving the value. Okay, so I have, in order to get the values, says value text dot text equals registry dot get value. Key name, as you notice up here, value name, value. Okay, very very easy. I declared all the variables for it. Okay, and now this is for the write button. When you double click on the write button in your IDE, you can declare three more variables, which is the same thing as above. Just copy and paste it right in there. Okay. In order to set the values, registry.setValue, key name, value name, value. Okay. Make sure you put your three text boxes in there. Okay, if you don't want to show your text boxes, just choose set them as not visible upon load time or whenever the form loads. Okay, so make sure you import Microsoft.132 and everything else should work out just fine. Let's go ahead and run the application. Let's start debugging. I'll make sure we save it. Build it, play it. Okay. I just got to do one thing over here first. I don't want to show my icon. And I don't want it showing up in the taskbar. Okay. Let's go ahead and push play. As you can see, I have the value already entered into the text box on top. Okay, the next folder that's inside there and the value that we want to edit. So let's go ahead and read. Oh shit, I didn't know that was in the shell. I forgot all about that. Anyway, we could fix this by simply typing in what we want to put in there and then hitting the right button. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to go ahead and type explore.exe. And next, I'm going to go ahead and hit the right button. Uh-oh, looks like my virus protection down here came up. This is, something's going on. Alright. So I have the registry opened up down here. Okay. Go ahead and go inside here. As you can see, I'm in WinLogin folder already. Windows Net. Microsoft Software 8 and then I'm HK local machine. Okay, software, next, Microsoft. Windows Net. WinLogon. And we go inside the WinLogon folder inside the registry. Let's go and double click inside there to edit the value. And as you can see, Explorer will load when Windows starts now. And said a Bobby sucks big time. Okay? Let's go ahead and push the OK button. Now we can edit the value inside this right here. We can type something else and then we'll have our program read and see if it's right. If it's right, if it's been written. Alright, as you can see, I've edited the string value inside here. I said LLL. Actually, maybe should I change this here? There you go, that's better. LLL. Hello, YouTube. Hello, world. There you go, let's go ahead and push OK. Now, instead of Explorer, when Windows starts, that will be started when Windows starts. So let's go inside here and see if the value... As you can see, it works. Okay, let's go ahead and write Explorer back into the registry. Go ahead and push the right button. Okay, and let's go back inside of our registry. And let's see exactly. And yes, it did work. Okay, so that is, my video tutorial for registry, read and write, how to make executable programs and Windows applications running under the .NET framework. Stay tuned for more exciting videos on more interesting subjects. Thanks a lot for watching. Make sure you subscribe and rate as well. Thank you.